Hello students and welcome back in second part of today's lecture. So here is our next numerical. A truck driver slows down the truck from 66 km per hour to 30 km per hour in 10 seconds. Find the retardation. Okay, so here time is given 10 seconds and two velocities are given. Okay, now first of all let me tell you what is retardation. So as we all know that change in velocity is called acceleration, but it is called acceleration when the change is in positive direction. That means when the velocity is increasing, that time it is called acceleration, but when the velocity is decreasing, that time it is called retardation. Okay, so here initially the bus was going with a speed of 66 km per hour, so this is our initial velocity and this is our final velocity 30 km per hour. Okay, and to reach from 66 to 30, how much time the bus has taken? It has taken 10 seconds, so this is our time. And we have to find out retardation, so basically we have to find out the acceleration only. So whenever this thing comes, okay, that find the retardation, so we use the formula of acceleration. Okay. So from the first equation of motion we have this formula, acceleration A equals to V minus U upon T. Okay, so first let's find out the value of V minus U. So here you can see V means final velocity and U means initial velocity. When we put the value, we got minus 36 km per hour. Okay, now this is in kilometer per hour, so first we have to convert it in meter per second. That we do by multiplying it by 5/18. Okay, so here we have got minus 10 meter per second. By putting this value here and the value of time, we get minus 1 meter per second. Okay, so our retardation is how much? So retardation here is 1 meter per second. Okay, when we are writing retardation, we need not to write minus sign here. If we write acceleration, that time we will write minus sign here. Okay, because negative sign denotes that this acceleration is in negative direction, but when we are writing retardation, we can simply give up the negative sign. So retardation here is 1 meter per second square. Now the next numerical. An airbus runs on a runway from rest. Okay, airbus, that means this aeroplane. Okay, it runs on a runway from rest, that means initial velocity is zero. Its final velocity is 810 km per hour. The length of the runway is 1000 meters. So distance is given here. Okay, what we have given here? Initial velocity, final velocity and distance. And we have to calculate the acceleration. Okay, in our previous examples we have given time with velocities, so that time by using the first equation of motion we have find out the acceleration, but here time is not given. Okay, time is not given. In place of that, what we have given? We have given the distance. So which formula is there in which velocity, distance and acceleration is there? That is the third equation of motion. Okay, in third equation of motion we need not to put the value of t. If we don't have the value of t but have the value of s, a or v, something like that. Okay, so we use this formula, third equation of motion. We have various equation of motion, first, second and third. In that different values are given. In first equation there is no role of distance. Okay, in third equation there is no role of time, but in second equation we have all the values together, distance, velocity, time and acceleration. But in that second one we don't have final velocity v. Okay, so according to what values are given, we have to choose the proper formula which will fit in that particular values. Okay, so here initial velocity is 0, final velocity is 810 meter per hour, so we will convert it in meter per second, so we get 225 meter per second. Here, distance covered is given 1000 meter. We convert it in SI unit, so it become 1 kilometer. Okay. Whenever we are solving any question, so we have to convert all the physical quantities in one unit. So here, meter per second, kilometer, these all are SI unit. Okay. Then we have to find out A. So by this relation, 2AS equals to V square minus U square, we put all the values and solve this. So we get A equals to this much. By solving this, we get 25.31 meter per second square. Okay, you can pause the video and note down the solution here. Now let us solve a numerical in which second equation is used. Okay, so a metro train accelerated uniformly from rest to a velocity of 180 kilometer per hour. Okay, so uniform acceleration is there. It starts from rest, that means initial velocity is 0 and final velocity is 180 kilometer per hour in half minute. So here time is given half minute, that is 30 seconds. Find the distance covered by the train in this time. Okay, we have to find out the distance. But we don't have direct formula where we can put the value of u, v and t to find out the distance. We don't have that direct formula. Okay, to find out the distance in second equation of motion and in third equation of motion, we have given distance. Okay, the formula contains distance, but there one more thing is there, which is acceleration. So to find out the distance, we must know the acceleration. So first, by using the first equation of motion, we will find out the acceleration. And this we will do as we have done in our first numerical. Initial velocity 0, time is 30 second. Final velocity is given in kilometer per hour. We convert it in meter per second. So we get 50 meter per second. Then using the first relation, V equals to U plus AT, we get A equals to 5 upon 3 meter per second square. Okay. Now to find the distance, we use the second equation of motion. S equals to ut plus half at square. Yes, you can use the third equation also. That's upon u. In third equation also, by putting all the values, we can find out the value of s. But here we are using the second one. So here u into t, that means 0 into 30 when we put. So this term will become 0 plus half at square. So half into value of a into value of t square. When we solve this, we get 750 meter. So this is the distance which is covered by this metro train. Okay. So I hope you all have understood how to solve the numericals by the three equations of motion. Okay. Now this is it for today's lecture. In next lecture, we will discuss the numericals related to graphs. We will solve some numericals related to graph. Till then, goodbye. Take care and do some productive work, and the most important thing, be safe, be healthy.